Esther works as a gender-based violence program coordinator in Liberia. Recently, she noticed a change in their usual number of reported cases. That made her think, how accessible is our GBV program? Esther knows that even where services are available, they may not be accessible to all survivors. There are many reasons why gender-based violence survivors find it difficult to access services. The cost of services, the distance to services, services not being accessible to women and girls from outside the local area, a lack of trained female staff, a lack of security or feeling safe, or a lack of privacy and confidentiality in services, or even a negative perception of services in the community and community beliefs about sexual purity or family honor, family pressure to not seek services, perceptions that services are not available or friendly to certain groups of people, and negative repercussions for disclosing the violence. Then finally, there are also administrative barriers, such as requirements to obtain documentation from the police before being able to access medical treatment, and a lack of an official identity documentation. To answer her question, Esther decided to review the key performance indicators to learn more about this issue and noticed something interesting when looking at the reporting delays indicators. This indicator counts and categorizes the number of days that have passed between when the survivor experienced gender-based violence and when the survivor first reported it to a service provider. Esther noticed that the number of reported cases dropped at the same time that the reporting delays worsened. With this information, she held a meeting with case management supervisors from the sites affected to better understand the issue. After discussion, they realized a recent local government mandate requiring documentation of assault be obtained from the police before seeking additional services. This was causing a significant delay in or deterring survivors entirely from accessing services. Esther and her GBV colleagues in her organization and peer organizations came together to do joint advocacy on this issue with government officials. They used the quantitative indicators with the qualitative information from case management staff to make their case. This is just one example of how you can use the key performance indicators to more accurately or effectively make programmatic decisions.